Hello everyone, welcome to the first video of the new playlist Verbal Reasoning. So in this playlist I'll be discussing about various forms of questions what we get in verbal reasoning for competitive exams. So in this video we will see about analogies. So basically analogies are used for comparison and comparing between any two entities, and we try to highlight the relationship or the similarity between the two parameters or between the two entities what we are taking. So we will solve some 25 analogy related questions in this video. Okay, so coming to the first question, so we have like petal, flower, and he is asking which is the correct answer in this. So if you see here, first of all, for solving questions related to analogy, one has to understand what is the relationship between the things given in the question first. So then only if you have a clarity on the relationship between the two things given in the question, then we will understand what could be the relationship amongst the options and which could be the correct options. So if you see the first question here, it's petal and a flower. So we all know that petal is a part of a flower. Okay, so in this similarity we have to check for the options. So if you see the options, we have pen and paper. So pen is not a part of a paper, so this option could be wrong. And if you see engine and car, yes, engine is a part of a car, so there is a probability of this answer. And if you see cat and dog, they are completely wrong, no match between them. And ball and a game, some might think a ball is also part of a game, but here the game is not specified. So ball can be a part of a game or cannot be a part of a game. So this option is also not correct. So finally, engine or car is the correct answer. Let's see the second question, frame and a picture. So let us try to understand what is the relationship between frame and a picture. So we all know that a frame is the one which surrounds the picture. So you have a photo frame, right? So a picture frame. So you have a picture and somebody is surrounding that, that is called as frame. So let's see what are the options. We have criminal and crime. No, this is not the right answer. We have river and forest. No. And we have nail and hammer. No, because hammer is not surrounded by nail. But if you see binding and book, yes, book is covered by binding, or book is protected by binding, or book is the one which surrounds the binding. So this is the right answer. Let's see the third question related to analogy. So the question is, a thermometer is to temperature, like means a thermometer is used to measure temperature. Then what is a compass used to? So we all know that thermometer measures the temperature. So what will a compass measure is what we have to find out the answer. Is it pressure? No, because pressure is measured by either a manometer or a barometer. Humidity? No. Direction? Yes. A compass basically measures the direction. It will show us the directions, north, south, east, west. Needle? No. So the correct answer is direction. Moving on to the fourth question, marathon is to race as hibernation is to. So marathon is to race. So marathon is a terminology related to race. Basically marathon is nothing but a long distance race. So if the race, running race or the walking race is for kilometers, we call it as a marathon. Then what is hibernation to? So hibernation is also something related to a long duration. So hibernation is basically, few people know, it is a deep sleep that help animals, basically like polar bears, to survive in the winters. So hibernation is to bear. Bear? No. And is hibernation is to dream? No. Hibernation is to sleep. Okay. And it is also not to winter. So marathon is to a race. So hibernation is to sleep. And next question. Chef and a restaurant. So I think by this time you have understood how to crack the analogy. So a chef is a person who works at a restaurant. So this is saying that this is talking about a person who is working in this place. So now let's see what are the answers, like what are the options. Doctor treatment? No. Doctor gives treatment, but doctor doesn't work in treatment. Driver car? No. Driver drives a car. Teacher school? This is correct. A teacher works in a school. writer, blog? No. So the correct answer is teacher and school. Let's see the next one. Myopia and eye. So myopia is basically a disease which is related to eye. Disease in the sense, myopia is a sort of blur vision where people can see closer objects clearly and objects which are far away in a blurred pattern. So that's called as myopia. So myopia is something related to the eye. So we will see the what does the same relationship in the other in the options have. So if is it first one, gastritis, stomach. So gastritis is related to stomach, yes. Dialysis is kidney, okay. Neuron, brain, respiration and lung. So if you see, dialysis is a process of removing water from blood. Neuron is related to brain, like neurons are present in the brain for processing. And respiration is the process which is performed by the lung. So these three talk about the processes, okay. But gastritis is a disease related to stomach, where your stomach lining becomes red in color. So this option is correct. The next one is joke and laughter. So joke and laughter is if somebody cracks a joke, we end up laughing. Means once somebody cracks a joke, we result in laughter. So if I am doing this parameter, I will be ending up with this parameter. So this is a relationship between both. So let's see. Story, mystery. No, because story can be mysterious or story can be comedy. No. Horror, fear. Yes, if I am horrified, I end up in fear. This is correct. Let's see other options also. Eyes, tears. No, if there are eyes, it's not that you have tears. Actor, acting. This is also no. So the answer is horror and fear. Next question. Careful is to careless as honest is to. So careful, careless. So both are opposite entities or antonyms. Like if you are careful, then the opposite of careful is careless. So now we have to check. You have the word called honest. Then what will be the opposite of honest? So honest, honest, absolutely wrong. Clever, wrong. Truthful, wrong. Correct. Corrupt is the correct answer, because we generally say he is an honest officer, he is a corrupted officer. So opposite of honest is corrupt here. So option D is correct. Let's see the ninth question. A leader is to guide as reduce is to. So leader is to guide. So the relationship between leader and guide is both are synonyms. So if somebody is leading you, means it is that somebody is guiding you. Then he is asking, what is the synonym for reduce? So if reduce is as simple as that, decrease. Next is, 10th one. Mumbai, Maharashtra. Then what is the gap here with Rajasthan? So one has to understand that Mumbai is the capital city of Maharashtra. So what should be the capital city of Rajasthan? So we all know Rajasthan's capital is Jaipur. So option B is correct. Next one, frugal, parsimonious. Then what are the other two things which match this? So frugal and parsimonious, first we should understand what is the meaning of both. Frugal and parsimonious are synonyms of each other, which mean being stingy. So if somebody is stingy, then you call them as frugal or parsimonious. So both words mean same. So now we have to check for options where both words mean the same. So if you see poor and misery, no. Love, hate, no. Rich, poor, no. So the correct answer is pleasure and ecstasy. Both have the same meaning. They have the similar meaning. Question number 12. A paw is for a cat. Then hoof is for what? So basically the foot of a cat is called as paw. We say a cat's paw, a lion's paw. So it's a foot of a cat. Then hoof is what? So hoof is the foot of a horse. So option B is correct. The next question. Race, fatigue. Fast, what? So basically race causes fatigue. Means if I'm running, I end up with fatigue. Means I feel, a kind of fatigue feeling I get. Like I feel uneasy. Then fast is what? So you do fasting, you end up with hunger. So hunger is the right answer. Next, 14th question. Water pitcher. What is for a vase? So this is very easy to answer. Basically, we all know pitcher is a device, or a pitcher is a thing which is used to store water. So we generally say water pitcher or a water jug. A jug kind of thing. So pitcher is generally used to store water. Then what is stored in a vase? Simple. Flowers. We have a flower vase. So what is for December if May has summer? So we all know that May is the month of summer season. So obviously December is the month of winter season. So the option is winter. Next is itch is what is for what? If you get hunger, you eat. So we generally know hunger makes us to eat something, makes us want to eat something. So obviously itch will make you what? Itching action will make you what? Makes you to scratch. So the option is scratch. Next we have computer. To what if human has heart? So generally when you relate to human being, you know heart is the main organ. So when you relate to computer, what is known as the heart of a computer? So basically heart of a computer is CPU, central processing unit. Next is Pacific Ocean. And Greenland is for what? So we all know Pacific is an ocean. So Greenland is what? It's as simple as that. It is the island of island. And we all know that Greenland is the largest island in the world. Next is zoology, animals. And etymology, what? So we know that zoology is the study of animals. So etymology is called as study of glands. And we have hypsiphobia, height, hylophobia, what? So one has to understand that hypsiphobia is the fear of heights. So some people generally have the fear of height. So when they go to greater height, when they see down, they get fear. Or they are not even able to climb up to heights. That's called as hypsiphobia. And so hylophobia is to what? So basically hylophobia is the fear of forest. Nepal, Kathmandu, Bhutan is for what? So things are simple. The capital of Nepal is Kathmandu. So obviously the capital of Bhutan is Thimphu. We have Photoshop software, keyboard for what? So we all know that Photoshop is a kind of software we use for editing the photos. So then what is a keyboard? Keyboard is not a driver. Keyboard is not a window. Keyboard is a hardware. Rat plague. Dogs what? So basically rats cause a disease called plague. So what is the disease caused by dogs? It is as simple as that. Rabies. So rabies is the disease which is caused by dog bites. Yeah. Next one is a duck, cricket, dunk, what? So duck here is a word which is related to cricket. It is the word which is associated with cricket. We generally use the word called duck out, right? So it's a terminology which is related to cricket. So dunk is the terminology related to what? So dunk is a term which is associated with basketball. So it's a type of basketball shot. And the last analogy for this video, Red Fort, Delhi, Taj Mahal is what? So most of you has, I think, already cracked the answer. So we all know that Red Fort is situated in Delhi. So obviously Taj Mahal is located in Agra. So this is all about analogies, people. I hope I could have given you some awareness about cracking the analogies. First, try to understand the relationship between the parameters given in the question. Check for the same relationship in the options. And that's it for this video. Hope you all understood the video. For more content related to verbal reasoning, kindly do subscribe. Thank you.